Hey yo, what is up guys, my name is Anvith and you're watching Hacks and Geeks. This is the third and final part of Building Lineage OS series. If you haven't checked out the previous parts, I'll put the links below in the description and also in the YouTube cards above. And in this video, I'll be showing you guys how to fix the common errors that you may face while building Lineage OS. Also, the link for the blog post will be under the description where you'll find all the links with the commands that you'll need. Let's begin with error number 1, which is proprietary blobs error. Well, it is not actually an error, but it's just the part that I left out in the previous part as it's rather confusing. When you run the breakfast command, you may get an error like this. But even if the breakfast command works while you use the branch command, it may terminate giving you an error which may look like this. Lineage OS recommends you to connect your device for which you are building Lineage OS, then through ADB run the extract files.sh command, but this step you still may face a lot of problems, not to mention that if you are using some cloud services to build Lineage OS, or maybe you are building Lineage OS for a friend's device and you don't have the device with you right now, etc. So there's a simple solution to this, and frankly a lot of people that I know use the same procedure to get the proprietary blobs. It's called the Muppets repository in GitHub. Now open the terminal and enter this command. Once the text editor opens up, go over to the Muppets repository in GitHub and then click on manifests. Now click on raw and copy these lines of code and paste it in the open text editor. Here you'll find all the manufacturer name and the file location. Now you can choose to keep all the lines, but this may take up a lot of space and time. Or you can just keep the lines where your device manufacturer is listed. For example, I'm building Lineage OS for OnePlus and Motorola devices. So I can just keep the line that says OnePlus and the other line which says Motorola, then delete all the other lines. Once this is done, you'll have to save and exit the file. Now rerun the reposync command. This will download the proprietary blobs for all the manufacturer that you have enlisted above. Now if you run the breakfast command with your device codename, this process should complete without an hiccup. This leads us to the second error called Ninja Wrapper error. This error appears when you run the branch command, which may look like this, and in the end it says Ninja Wrapper error. Before attempting to run the next command to fix the issue, take a look at what it says. I wasn't able to recreate this error and had to fill up my storage device to get this error. And it shows that there is no space left, and only then it shows the ninja error. So I can just free up my disk space and the issue will be solved. But sometimes it just shows some bizarre errors and possibly the errors that you may not know of. Then you can run the below command to disable the ninja wrapper. Finally, the Jack compiler error. I have talked about this in the previous parts, but still, even after fixing this, the error may show up again, which looks like this, and says to try and increase the Java heap size using the XMS size option. Now, if you remember how much size you had allocated using this command previously, try increasing it by a GB or two. I had allocated around 4 GB there, so now I'll put 6 GB. Also, now I have to edit the bash/rc file using this command. And then, at the end of the file, change the command that you had pasted there with the new size that you have allocated now. Yep, that's all for the errors. Now if you want to build nightly builds for your device, then just run these commands. First type repo sync, which will sync all the latest changes from Lineage OS GitHub repository. Then type source/build env setup.sh and then breakfast with your device codename. And finally, branch with your device codename. And that's it, copy the build to your Android device and flash the file using in custom recovery like TWRP and enjoy your own custom built Lineage OS. Well, that's it for this video and this series guys. If you have any ideas for what our next video or the series should be, comment down below. And thank you for watching the video guys. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then a like rating will be awesome. For more videos from us, subscribe to your YouTube channel and I'll see you in the next one.